Welcome to 101 Labs GIAC Security Essentials course, Lab 91, Metasploitable Brute Force FTP with Hydra. This lab demonstrates one of the many vulnerabilities that exist in the Metasploitable VM that can be exploited to gain remote access or remote command execution. In this lab, we will be demonstrating how Hydra, a powerful tool for brute forcing passwords on network services, can be used to gain unauthorized access to an FTP server. We'll be using the Hydra tool from our Kali Linux VM against our Metasploitable VM. Task one is to discover the vulnerable service. The first stage of any attack is discovery. Let's run an nmap scan against the Metasploitable, querying all ports with an attempt at service detection, which we can also reference in future labs for service discovery. On Kali, run the following command: sudo nmap the Metasploitable IP -sv -p. The argument -sv instructs nmap to probe open ports to determine what service version is running, while the -p- argument tells nmap to query every port rather than just the default most common ports. So we'll hop over to our Kali VM and we will enter that nmap command. So this is performing service detection against all ports on the Metasploitable VM. This can take quite a while to run, so we'll return when it's finished. Task two is probing the FTP service. Let's take a look at the FTP service by connecting manually. In the terminal window on Kali, enter the following to establish a connection to the FTP server: FTP Metasploitable IP. Note that the version of the FTP software running is displayed to us. This can be useful information when researching any available exploits. We are prompted for a username and then a password. For now, attempt to log in with the same username and password that you use for Kali, and note that we are not authorized to access this FTP server. So back on our Kali VM, we can see our nmap scan is complete, and we can attempt the manual FTP connection. So FTP and the Metasploitable IP address. We enter a username, in this case Kali, we enter a password, and we see that we are not authorized to log in. Task 3 is brute force the FTP service. We will use Hydra with a username and password list to see if this FTP service is vulnerable to any weak common credentials. For this attack, we supply Hydra with a username list and a password list. Hydra, in its default configuration, we'll then attempt to log in as each username with every password. For demonstration purposes, create a users.txt file and a passwords.txt file, each with the same content. And listed here is the usernames and passwords that should be in each of those two files. This attack will essentially be testing for default login credentials that haven't been changed and a weak passwords that match the username. In a real-world attack, much larger lists may be used. Run the following command to begin the attack using the two custom files we created. Note that we supply the service we are attacking at the end of the command, in this case FTP. So Hydra -l in the path to the users.txt file, -p path to the passwords file, the Metasploitable VM followed by the service FTP. So we enter that command here into Kali. Our users.txt and passwords.txt file are in the same directory, so we can enter the relative path. We supply the IP for Metasploitable and the service FTP, and the attack begins. And as we can see, it will give some feedback when it finds valid and correct credentials. In this case, with this short username and password list, we found two valid accounts. The results show that we get a successful match for the user and Postgres accounts. Let's now confirm our access. Open an FTP connection again as in the previous task, this time entering the credentials for Postgres. Once you have a connection, run an FTP command such as ls to confirm we have access. So again, over in Kali, we will repeat the manual FTP connection. This time we'll enter the valid account we found from the brute force attack and the password, and we see we have access. That concludes this lab. See you in the next one.